But India is an agricultural country. In the last few decades, there were changes in the agricultural practices from small to large, emphasizing the agricultural productivity. According to this strategy, many farmers are using chemical fertilizers export from American countries, but they are not taking our crops to their countries because we are using their chemical fertilizers. It is our liquid bio fertilizer from vegetable waste. We should take the rotten vegetables in a bottle and we should store it for 4 months. For 60 days its color is like this and its count is 6.0 log CFU per ml. For 75 days it is 5.5 log CFU per ml. This difference because of the microorganisms decrease from 60 days to 75 days. For 75 days, the decrease in the bad bacteria present in this rotten vegetables. From 75 days, there's an increase in the good bacteria and molds which help for the crop productivity. 90 days, it reaches 6.5 log CFU per ml. When it reaches 6.5 log CFU per ml, it can be used as a liquid bio fertilizer. We are using nitrogen fertilizer, nitrogen chemical fertilizer, potassium chemical fertilizer, phosphorus chemical fertilizer. But in this liquid bio fertilizer, there is phosphorus, potassium and nitrogen. All the primary nutrients are present in this liquid bio fertilizer. Phosphorus content is present from 0.09 to 0.12. And like the same quantities are present in potassium, nitrogen in this liquid bio fertilizer. There is a reduce in the sugar content from 60 days to 90 days, because if there is a sugar content in liquid bio fertilizer, it damages the crop. If there is no sugar content in this liquid bio fertilizer, it gives good productivity to the crop. We should use this liquid bio fertilizer during the growing stage of this crop. We prepared this liquid bio fertilizer and we gave to the Acharya Nagarjuna University biochemist, and he is testing that. He is testing with a viable cell count meter about the viable cell count of this liquid bio fertilizer after 90 days. He justified that it reaches 6.5 log CFU per ml, and he said that it can be used as a liquid bio fertilizer. We gave this to the farmers and he used this liquid bio fertilizer, but these two did not use this liquid bio fertilizer. That's why their crop is just failed, but he got more growth of that groundnut crop. See, sir, here less leaves and more groundnut, and here less groundnut and more leaves, because they did not use this liquid bio fertilizer. The difference between solid and liquid bio fertilizer is, solid bio fertilizer takes time to dissolve in water and the plant takes more time to grasp the solid bio fertilizer, but it can be easily grasped by the plant because it is in liquid form. That's why it can be mixed with water in 1:2 ratio. Means if we take 1 liter of liquid bio fertilizer, we should mix it with 2 liters of water and we should spray in this crop fields. If we spray in the crop fields, it gives more growth. In tobacco plants, the leaf is like this, but after using this liquid bio fertilizer, it increases the after using this liquid bio fertilizer, the leaf becomes excellent. And for cotton, After using this liquid bio fertilizer, we got more cotton. In this crop, we gave this liquid bio fertilizer to the farmer, and he is saying that this we got more yield of that crop. We get this rotten vegetables from the right market. On the way to our school, there's a right market. We thought we are getting rotten smell every day. We asked our sir, how can we prepare a liquid bio fertilizer from this, sir? We asked our sir. He said that we can prepare a liquid bio fertilizer and it can be used to the farmers. It is of very cheap cost and it can be used by the farmers, and it is easy to spray because it does not cause any harm to the farmers like chemical fertilizers. Chemical fertilizers consists of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium and some other chemicals also. They cause harm to the farmers. But in this liquid bio fertilizer, the nitrogen content, phosphorus content and potassium content is of small contents, and it gives good growth to the farmers.